are going to work in new fields, new technologies.
Many of you will work in new fields and new technologies that we haven't even thought about yet.
And to our graduate students, thank you for your hard work and commitment to your education. Congratulations on your academic accomplishments, and please know that we wish you much success as you start a new phase in your life. Don't forget that you can always return to this campus to further your education by getting a master's degree. Hope you all have a great day and a memorable experience. Thank you.
The amount of energy that hits the planet is about the same amount that the planet uses in a year, which is significant. So every hour, the amount of energy that hits the planet from the sun is about the same as the entire planet uses in a year. We're basically squandering our energy resources, is the bottom line, and burning fossil fuels instead of using appropriate energy. There really is a breakthrough, I think, in this kind of technology coming soon. There are people, just like in Edison's time, there are people all over the world working on incandescent lighting systems. At this point in the game, there are people all over the world working on nanotechnology-based solar systems. It's pretty obvious to the scientific community at this point that there are the tools available to be able to fix the energy problem.
Vehicles per day entering and leaving the site. And then we also wanted to calculate the peak hour, which is just the hour where there's the most traffic coming in and out of the site.
They're all based on using Bluetooth. But the problem is Bluetooth, you walk away from the device and it doesn't talk to the device anymore. So we use cell phones to update people.
In the start of the kind of the fourth industrial revolution, which kind of has been a merge of the digital automation age, and you know, it's pretty active at this point. From a technology standpoint, it's very exciting. And you know, desktop printing, the cloud computing, big data, merging of cyber and physical systems. It's a pretty exciting time to be a technologist, to be an engineer. So the real point that I want to make is you're going to spend most of your waking hours working. So the only real advice I have is, you know, love what you do and try to do it well.
It feels like you're in like a room, or you're actually in the crash landing, and you can look around and have 360 view of everything around you. It was pretty difficult, but fun at the same time.
The premise of this game is that you've crash landed on a space planet, and your ship's broken. So now you're programming your little robot to get the ship parts back. It's our way of teaching like basic programming concepts to people in VR. So we have like little blocks that are like actions, so you can move, turn, pick up. So it's just to introduce beginners to programming concepts while having fun in VR.
A child detection system that is designed to monitor the temperature and monitor the movement within the car. Here, this is the car seat with the integrated pressure system as well as the temperature sensor. For us, our initial temperature is 80 to 85, and as soon as it hits that point, it starts calculating. The first three sections is 2.5 minutes, and after 2.5 minutes between the three sections, there's a 2.5 minute gap, and it calls the police. So within 5 minutes, the child must be picked out of the car within the first 5 minutes of the car.
It's a pick and place machine project that Ed and I did with, you know, the help of Professor Vintonigan and Dr. Kazai. I'm going to start by homing it. Now I'm going to move it to where it thinks that the corner of the circuit board is. So actually, I'm going to set the where it thinks that the corner of the circuit board is and start the job. Found the first fiducial, second fiducial, and now it's going to start placing. I can hear the solenoid valve clicking. That's sending the vacuum through to the tip and releasing it to ambient pressure to drop the part. And now it's doing the machine vision to locate the little parts.
Idea of a Micromouse, which is an autonomous robot with the idea of search and rescue, because in my opinion there's not enough technological investigation and developments in the search and rescue field, and I feel like technology should be used to our advantage and should be used to search for people when a disaster comes. I built three subsystems from scratch. I built an IR proximity sensor, which is these four sensors in the front. They sense proximity, so once they get close to something, they sense it, and then it changes direction. Everything that it's doing, it's showing in the screen. So basically, it goes straight. Once it detects the wall, it's going to stop. Then it's going to change direction. It's going to keep going. And
is it a random angle that it's picking?
No, everything's predetermined with the code. The first time it does, yeah, it is 90. And then, so now that it's done three times, the sensor comes on. The sensor, it does it all that range, and now it's going to sense this range. So now I'm here, it's going to sense me. It's going to get close. Every time that it senses me, it's going to get closer. And then, since there's a wall, it's not going to keep coming. It's going to get stuck there. And then, once it decides that I'm here, it's not going to move anymore.
I am an engineer. In my profession, I take deep pride.
In my profession, I take deep pride.
Thank you very, very much. Now, the students deserve all the credit, really, because without the students, we wouldn't be here, right? I really wish you the best. Good luck with your future.
The members are Shakir Cohen, Evan Faster, Trang Ganguyen, Melissa Orlandini, Van Schuster, Howard Wilson, and Robert Zenzel. Shubnam Analdas, Cody Franson, Atreya Nagesh, Thomas Palmer. Our group, Edward Gilbert and Bernard Weaver. First place winner is Planet Football. Members Kamal Amarzak, Amara, Longway.